Hey friends, you may be familiar with websites that can show you a map with like houses for sale within a given area, and you wondered, how do they do that? Well, Azure Maps enables you to find the latitude and longitude, you know, the geocode, for thousands of addresses in one call, and to search locations within the boundaries of a specific geographical area, like a city or a postal code. And Julie is here to show us how that works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Julie Kohler, who's going to talk to me about Azure Maps. We've got a couple things today. We got batch geocoding and some cool polygon stuff with administrative areas. Let's talk about batch geocoding first.
Yeah, so batch geocoding really lets you pass up to 10,000 different geocoding calls in a single call.
Seriously?
Yes.
That's quite a batch.
Yeah, it's quite a large batch, and depending on how many you pass, it will take, you know, a different amount of time.
Okay.
But we do support up to 10,000 because it's not extremely slow to pass that many geocoding calls. So what you can do is if you, say, have tons of addresses that you want to get the latitudes and longitudes for, you can pass those in a single batch call. We will charge by transaction, so if there were 1,000 there, it would be the cost of 1,000 transactions.
Cool.
But that runs in the background, and so you can wait for that to complete.
Okay.
You can make other calls, do other API calls that you need to do, or go about your business, and then you check on that later, and you'll have all of those 1,000 calls come back to you with that information all at one time.
Now, is geocoding something that is reversible?
Yes. So we have geocoding, and we have reverse geocoding, and we batch both of those.
Okay, so which one is which?
So geocoding is when you pass an address.
Okay.
And you get back the latitude longitude, and the reverse is passing the latitude longitude and getting back the address information or the location information.
I see. So I can see where I'm going to go and populate a map, like we said, with houses for sale.
Mm-hmm.
I pass you a bunch of addresses, and I need the latitude and longitude to put pins down.
Exactly.
Or, I don't know, graphics with little houses and money on top,
mm-hmm.
right? And then the address one is like I'm driving and I'm passing latitude and longitude. My GPS is telling me where I'm at. You tell me the address of the house I'm looking at.
Yes.
Or the house or houses? Is there a fuzziness to reverse geocoding?
Yeah, you can get back more than that. And you can even get back street addresses, like cross streets and things like that with reverse geocoding.
Can you think of a reason I would want to send 10,000 of something in?
Yeah, for the example that you said, maybe you want to map a bunch of houses on a map and you know they're for sale and you want to show pins where they are. You send us 1,000, we'll give you 1,000 results back. Or even something like I want to show all of my stores in the state of Washington on a map.
Oh,
you
wow.
pass
That's
us their location
point.
Or their addresses, and we will put the pin for the, or you can put the pin for the location on the map.
And there's two things that are interesting that you said that I think maybe the audience doesn't realize how useful it is you can do these calls and keep doing other calls.
Mm-hmm.
So basically Azure Maps scales for you.
Yes.
You're being paid per transaction, but you're not thinking about the fact that you gave it a huge job. It just handles that huge job.
Yeah.
There's no slider bar for like how big of an Azure Maps thing that you want.
You're
right?
not blocked from doing anything else. You don't need to worry about scaling. You don't need to worry about how much time it's going to take before you can do the next thing. So we handle that all for you.
That's super cool. And then the second thing is when you make these long acting calls, you don't block at the HTTP level. Like you don't make my app wait. You say, eh, come back later.
Yeah. You get a 202 back and you can just come back and get the results when you're ready.
That's so cool. Do you got a demo for me?
I do. So let me show you a batch geocode first.
Okay.
So all I've passed here is my subscription key, and in the body, I've passed a number of queries. In this case, I've done 5 different queries that I want to know the location for.
Mm-hmm.
So I've done some things in Seattle, I've did one in New York. It can be anywhere, really, that you're searching for in this batch. It does not have to be even a single geographic location.
And before you start, you've got a couple of parameters I don't recognize, like limit equals 3 is one.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I understand why radius would be there, but what are the limits for?
Limit says I only want 3 results back. And so you can get points of interest back and things like that along with your result. And if you want to limit it and say, I don't want a ton of information about this, I just want, you know, the latitude, longitude, and give me maybe 3 possible results, that's what that means.
I see. Okay, cool. So can we run that one?
Yeah, let's run this.
So here is 5 different ones, and that comes back pretty fast. And is this one going to return a 202 as well?
This will. And this one might take a little bit longer, so I'm going to show you the reverse one as well. Very, very similar.
Okay.
But again, I just have my subscription key here. And in the body, I've got my queries. These are simply latitudes, longitudes. This one has given a radius as well and a limit, because
cool.
that's possible with these as well. So I will also do this call. And I'm going to go back to the original one, the batch geocode, and I'm going to take this location that it passed me back.
Mm-hmm.
Very simple. after I got my 202, I can now make this call.
Okay.
Simply post or paste this into mm-hmm. the get.
Cool.
And now I've got my results back. It was that quick. So here's my results back. I've got the address.
I noticed at the top it said number of requests and number mm-hmm. of successful requests.
Yeah.
So why might a request not be successful? Because of a vague address?
It could be something like that. It could be a bad value that was passed in, or maybe we weren't able to find the thing that mm-hmm. you were looking for.
Invalid latitude and longitude, yeah. out of range.
Any potential errors, and we'll let you know what the errors were.
Okay. So that one came back, and it gave you all the stuff you wanted. And like you pointed out, you can pass in additional things like points of interest or anything that you want.
Yeah.
All the different things that Azure Maps supports can be batched up like
yep.
this.
Yep, anything that we support in a typical geocode call, you can do in this batch as well.
Very cool.
And we can check on the results of the reverse geocode as well. Let's look at...
And you know that there's header. Probably people who have built solutions on Azure Maps that are watching this and going, oh, I'm going to go back right now and I'm going to refactor my code. Because some poor person out there has a for loop that they're doing and 10,000 is something, and now they're going to be thrilled to be able to refactor by subtraction.
This will greatly simplify things.
And simplify things and make their life a lot better.
And this one got results back as well. Also 5 requests, and then I get my search results back.
Interesting. And that one shows query time as well, too.
Yeah.
And this works anywhere. I see you have France and Redmond, so this is
yep.
a global thing. It's an important thing to remember.
Global service, yes. So that's what I wanted to talk about for batch.
Mm-hmm.
The second topic for today is talking about being able to get what we're calling an administrative area back.
Administrative area.
That yes.
sounds very official.
It's an official mapping term.
Okay.
And what it really means is a geographical boundary that's defined by man. And so when you say something like King County or the city of Seattle, it's a boundary that we've defined administratively. And so we recognize that these are the boundaries on a map, but really they're not things that exist in the physical world.
Okay, but those are administrative things like a county or a state that everyone pretty much agrees on. But my cousin sells pet food and he has his sales region.
Mm-hmm.
That only his company cares about. Can he make an administrative region?
If it was created inside of our services,
mm-hmm.
Maybe, but we don't support that today.
Okay, so that's possibly something for the future.
Something for the future that we could consider.
So this would be known public administrative areas?
Yes.
Okay, so counties and states and zip codes
mm-hmm.
and things like that?
Yes.
Cool.
So I'll show you how to do this, and I'll first show you in Postman, and then I have a visible demo as well.
Okay.
So the first thing you want to do is you want to make a search call to get that geometry back.
Okay.
And so what I've done here is I've done a query for Bellevue, Washington.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to send that query. And then when I get back in the results, you're going to see something. If I scroll down here.
Is there a thing that you can click up here at the top where it says authorization that would make this have more room?
Possibly.
I think there's a slider. I'm just wondering if like headers might make that less tall.
I found what I was looking for.
Okay, so that's the ID of the geometry?
Yeah, so we have this object, data sources, geometry, and then within there is the ID. So this is the ID of the geometry that we're giving you back for your search results, so
okay.
for Bellevue, Washington.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to take this ID and I'm going to copy this. And then we have an additional method that you call called getPolygon.
Oh.
And in here, I'm going to paste the ID of the geometry that I want back.
I see, and it says geometries. Plural, mm-hmm. so you could have comma.
You could do multiples here.
Okay, cool.
Then I'm going to send that in. And now I've gotten my results back. And so this actually will give me the coordinates and points that define that entire geometry for Bellevue, Washington.
I see. And then that would be easy for me to then draw the polygon on top of a map control and visualize that geometry within my business application.
Exactly. And I will show you an example of doing
no,
exactly that.
Oh, see, now you're just showing off. That's cool.
So what we have here, I did exactly what she said. So behind the scenes, when you type in what you're searching for here,
okay.
and for an example, let's just do Seattle.
Okay.
So behind the scenes, I do a search call.
Mm-hmm.
Then I get that geometry ID back, and then I draw it on the map based on what was returned to me.
Very cool. Can you do zip codes?
Yes, I can do zip codes as
Where
well.
Where are we, 98052?
We are, 98052. I'm going to give it a little bit of additional information so it understands
sure.
where I'm looking. And we've got a zip code as well.
And that's a complicated polygon. There's a lot going on there. Administrative areas are non-trivial. They're
it
not
is.
Usually squares.
And if you notice, this was all pretty fast.
Like, it was effectively instantaneous.
Yeah, and so we did the search, we got the area, we called for the additional data and got that geometry ID.
You're right, there were multiple calls there and it still was instantaneous.
Multiple calls and you can draw it very fast. I can also do things like, let's look for Detroit. Then we support other countries as well, so let's do Windsor. This is interesting because a lot of people don't realize Canada is actually south of Detroit. Yeah.
Canada's south of Detroit?
In this part it is.
Whoa. Oh, I've been there. I've actually been there and looked across the river and said, that's Canada over
there. That's
right. That's awesome.
So if you notice, this is a pretty complex polygon. There's parts that dip down and a complex shape, but we got all that back very quickly and were able to draw that on the map.
Yeah, it was basically in the time it took you to push the button on the up of the button. Two calls and painting the polygon.
And we even zoomed in the map to the exact location.
Right. And that speaks to what we said before when we were talking about batch geocoding is Azure Maps is scaling for you. So as a business user, you simply stop thinking about scale in this context and you really think about the mapping that you want to do, which is really cool.
Yeah. And anybody could build this demo today. We simply used our map control and the APIs that I just demoed and we were able to put this together pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm. And it's probably a dozen lines of code.
Yeah. It's really not that much.
So where can people go and learn more about this?
Yeah, so please go to our documentation site. We have documentation about all of our REST APIs. We have additional articles, but you can go here at docs.microsoft.com and learn about Azure Maps.
Very cool. I'm learning all about batch geocoding and polygons for admin areas here on Azure Friday.